About your forecast now. Well, the weekend was good.
And then my family was
focusing
like,
on the positive.
See, you're focusing on the positive. Usually I'm the one. But Sarah, I'm going to focus on the positive and then skip ahead to next Saturday.
You know, yeah, that's pretty much the positive in this 7-day forecast. I mean, we've got some cooler weather on the way, and with that, sure enough, some showers too. But you know what? I'd rather have showers on a Monday than on a weekend, so we'll take it for tomorrow. Today, 69 degrees. That was the high in Boston right after 1 o'clock and well above our average in the lower 50s. No record, though. That was back in 2010. Oh, I remember that spring. It was really hot, especially for Marathon Monday that year. As we take a look the conditions now, the clouds are thickening ahead of these showers that are going to be moving on in through the day tomorrow. In fact, overnight tonight, the risk of some showers, but it's still mild this evening. Shouldn't be a problem if you're headed out. Temperatures in the 50s, close to 60 right now, 40s for the Cape. And as we go through the overnight hours, we fall back into the 40s and 50s. But 8 o'clock, you're noticing the wet conditions. Early morning commuters likely going to see the risk of those showers picking up through that mid-morning commute. If you're traveling north, be aware you're going to run in to wintry weather. We've got a wintry mix, even snow across parts of central and northern New England. Now, I think southern New England, you'll stay mainly rain. May even hear a rumble of thunder, especially down across the south coast towards the midday hours. And the risk of these showers, they'll start to wind down in the afternoon, but just can't rule out that stray shower. Notice these temperatures, too, really going to be dependent on where we see that cooler weather, as temperatures in the 30s and 40s to the north, 50s down across the south, but no near 70 degrees is what we're expecting for our Monday. So much cooler weather, and it even gets cooler Monday night into Tuesday. We'll hold on to the clouds, that's for sure, and the winds will turn out of the north. So by Tuesday morning, you're waking up to temperatures in the 30s north and west, lower 40s for Boston, down across the Cape and Islands. But then we'll turn our attention to later in the day. Let's first talk about Monday's rainfall. Doesn't look to be too much. In fact, not really showing up much besides a couple tenths of an inch to about a half an inch of rain. So more of a nuisance out there. And if you're traveling north, take a look at the snowfall forecast. Yeah, some parts of Maine seeing over a foot of snow possible. Pretty intense from this system that will be coming on through. Again, I think southern New England will be a mainly rain. Now we get that break Monday night into Tuesday, but the system out of the west will be arriving later Tuesday. And with winds onshore, could lead to some pockets of mist, but also some scattered showers. The question is, how early do those showers arrive? Do they arrive early in the afternoon, or do they come later in the evening? So we're going to be, of course, narrowing down that timeline. But something to keep in mind, if you are headed to Fenway, it will be cool. Temperatures likely in the 40s with that risk of rain and mist out there. Now, if it stays a little bit later, temperatures could bump up closer to 50, like parts of the south. But Tuesday, you got to deal with that onshore wind, and that typically means the coolest conditions would be along the immediate coast. So you're noticing the changes headed our way with the cooler temperatures and the risk of rain. That will at least drop our pollen levels. So Monday and Tuesday looking pretty okay. Pollen levels, if you're an allergy sufferer, I'm sorry, they go back up by Thursday. But that's because we get some drier weather. And we also get temperatures that are going to rebound back to normal. So we've got to deal with those 40s below average conditions Tuesday and Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Sure enough, could be back to near 60 degrees. But unfortunately, that does come with our next chance of some scattered showers. You'll notice that front approaching from the west. So taking a look at our 7-day forecast here, of course, it's not going to be going through it, but there's that risk of those showers late Friday into early Saturday. But Sunday, as you said, you like to focus on the weekend, Katie. It looks pretty good, at least for Sunday. As for Monday, we'll have to watch for some showers. And of course, that's Marathon Monday. Not in my 7-day forecast, but something to keep in mind.